Urban Today, brought to you by
Metropolitan International University. We offer postgraduate diplomas, bachelor's degree, diploma, certificate programs, weekend, day and evening. Registrations in progress at our campuses.
Welcome back. You're still watching Urban Today. My name is Lynn Komjisha, and of course, we were speaking to Darren Bartlett. Lydia here was speaking to Darren Bartlett on matters of foreign and international in East Africa. There was quite interesting
Tanzania is still insisting.
It's quite shocking because, yeah? You see, when Magufuli came into power, people had a lot of hope. They respected him.
The bulldozer.
He was a bulldozer going against corruption, going against the problems in society. And now we see he's just sitting back. And I'm like,
he's playing around with people's lives, seriously.
Yeah. You see, I learned something from our leaders every other day, that they get hung on to power.
Yes.
They get drunk onto power, and it's something very disturbing.
I know, it's okay to be drunk on power. I mean, we've seen.
No, because you get
you
to
can
do
stay
mistakes.
In power for a long time. That is fine. But there are those who stay in power for a long time, but they actually put their people first. Mm. And with Tanzania, it's not like Tanzania has a lot of presidents come and go. You know. But so we are shocked that Magufuli is actually handling it.
Anyway, so our old man, Owana Tony Jaffra, is actually.
Hey, but there's Owana keeping it urban every morning.
Thank you, Mr.
We appreciate
Owana.
That.
How are you? We hope you're well. Now, he says, in Central Africa Republic, ex-French Army Sergeant Bokassa became president by force and was promoted to Field Marshal. A few years later, his status rose to Emperor, with he and his queen sitting on golden throne. So, Central Africa Republic issues date from
It's like they've been doomed right from the start, and they've been struggling ever since rebellion. And you have now a president who is cornered to a small section. 80% of the country has rebels all over the place. So,
and you know,
we
how
really hope for the best for this country that has now Russia and UN is there trying to help. The French are there, Rwanda is there.
Everyone is there, hoping
for more help, at least
nation.
From the African Union.
Yeah. It has
usually
resources.
That's what happens. Well, there are resources, you know, you're going to have a lot of the foreign interference that we're talking about.
Absolutely. Okay, now we could have that conversation the whole day, but now let's switch. Dina Nalwega Kamengo is in the field, and she's going to speak to a Metropolitan spokesperson, that is Onyango, and we're going to speak to him about, you know, there's a situation which NUP has distanced itself from, but people are worried that they cannot go to work.
Yes.
So let's speak to him in just now. Hello, Dina, are you there? How are you? Dina Muchala Kamengo, she's all clad in some Valentine mode.
Since yesterday, by the way.
Since Monday. Anyway, so we'll get back to Dina in just a bit. She's going to speak to Patrick Onyango, and we get to hear what plans are there. Because I was coming.
People were scared.
Yeah, people are scared. Mm. I was coming to work today, and there were police all over the place. They stopped us, actually. They stopped the company van. I'm thinking, what's going on? And then they look at us like, oh, these ones look fine.
Mm-hmm.
Go. They never said any word. They just said,
yeah, and they've been rounding up people, actually, on the streets of Kampala. The idlers, they rounded up quite a bit. And the police went ahead and said, it's not because of the audio and video that is going on.
Mm.
It's because we are just trying to keep the peace and do some security sweep. But, yeah, I think it's related.
All right, Dina, are you there now? How are you?
Good, Lynn, and a good morning to you.
Good morning to you, too. You look lovely in that Valentine attire.
Oh, yes. And you know I am with security, so.
Uh-huh. Please, take us away.
Anyway, good morning and good morning, Urban viewers. We are bringing you the security situation right here in Kampala. I am with Afande Patrick Onyango, the police spokesperson for the Kampala Metro.
Oh yes, you know, internet issues, you know. But
calm down, Seka. Patience, please.
She's definitely going to speak to Patrick Onyango, the Kampala Metropolitan Area spokesperson, police spokesperson, on this security issue. I have friends actually who work downtown. Like, they were, we're not going to work.
Yeah.
All right, let's quickly go back to dinner.
Elections were going to take place this year, and we had plans. So we had the plan of 1 year plan. We have been meeting for the past 1 year, and we have been meeting as a joint security force. That means. Folders to see that we police these elections, which we are concluding today, with the elections of chairpersons of LOC3, of sub counties that are going to be elected today.
Yeah.
So we had a master plan, security master plan, on detailing who is supposed to do what at what stage, who is supposed to do what at what point. So that plan was done by a joint security task force. And they came out with that plan. And that's why you see the elections were totally peaceful. The elections went on without any major incidents. Although some people were predicting and anticipating that there would be violence, but violence didn't happen because of the security plan, master plan we had.
Okay. Mm. Officer, when you talk about your security details being tight, you know, Ugandans are saying that the elections were violent, violence-free because you worked on the security. Kampala, some people around Kampala feel they were intimidated. You ripped them of their freedom to do whatever they wanted to do, not necessarily violent actions, but they were intimidated.
No, there was not any intimidation. What they are trying to mean is because of the deployment we had. But if we deploy security, if we have deployed security, it doesn't mean we are intimidating you. You see, people, especially from the other side, what they think that by deployment, that means you are intimidating people. Recently, when they are inaugurating the new president of USA, there was a lot of security detail. Was that also intimidating people? They were there to provide what? Security. So for us, when we provide security, they talk of intimidation. The other side, they say it is providing security, which is not the case. We are just purely and merely providing security by deploying. And in fact, I would ask members of the public, if you see a security personnel near you, you should be very happy. You should be feel free and know that, yes, the security man is here, the security lady is here. This means I'm free to do whatever I want, so long as it is lawful. But if it is unlawful, that means you are not supposed to do it. But if you are doing a lawful business, lawful duty, and security personnel are there, we're very happy to know that what? Security is there, but not that we are intimidating.
Okay.
You see, when we get information, when we get intelligence information of people planning violence, we cannot sit back and say we should not deploy because we are going to intimidate people.
Mm.
Because people will label us intimidators. No. We have to see that we deploy so that we avert that possible violence that people are planning. Yeah.
And Afande, there have been, even in today's paper, we've had crackdowns on people. People have been arrested.
Yeah.
So in this wake of the fear and all those things that are going on, and people are disappearing, some have been arrested, as per today's stories, but then there are others that are kidnapped, you know? So what do you expect a Ugandan to think?
No, you have said in today's paper there were operations that were carried out. Yesterday we carried out an operation within the city center to see that we keep the city clean, out of criminal. We don't want criminals to take the city. To take the city, that means we have no business. So we have to see that the city is clean. And that's why yesterday we were targeting, especially phone snatchers, pickpocketers, others who use drugs.
Mm.
Those ones we were arresting. The ones we are talking of, they are those who have been arrested and they are in custody.
Mm.
for participating in various crime. So, if you have any person you are talking of that either has been done this and you have a particular name, you give us that particular name, we verify with our security, with our intelligence, and in our database to find out who the person we are talking of.
So the people can come here and lodge their complaints?
Yes,
their
people can go to any police station, seen him, was arrested, and have not seen him come to police station, lodge your complaint, we shall investigate. And recently, the Deputy Inspector General of Police tasked the Director of Crime Intelligence, Director CID, to see that they come up or they investigate these allegations. Yeah.
What have been the hot spots for those crackdowns?
We were down yesterday around Nachivubo Muse, around the Nachivubo Channel, around William Street. Busy places where we suspect that the targets were. William Street, Baton Street, those areas.
So Ugandans should not speculate and say now this is the time they are picking our people off the streets.
No, they should not speculate. Because these are criminals. We even got them. Some of them, we got them with exhibits, like others got them with marijuana, jaga. This is a clear indication that they were participating in smoking with the knives that they were using to attack people. So those are clear indications that these were people who had plans or intent of committing a crime.
Afadi, have you heard of the stories going around on social media that Ensiko, you know the word Ensiko? That the Ensiko is nearby and people are preparing to go to Ensiko, and some people are calling upon Ugandans, and of course the bush, are calling upon Ugandans to plan for food, stay at home and not come to work.
What you are talking about is some video and audios that has been circulating in the social media saying that beginning today up to 7th of this month that there will be kind of a total lockdown.
Yeah.
They are planning to attack people. They are planning to do all sorts of things to members of the public. They are even advising members of the public not to go to work. And as you can see in the background, people are working, people are moving. They are anticipating, yes, we took it very serious, those allegations. We took those audios very seriously. And as a security team, we had to come up with a plan to see that we secure Ugandans. And I think if you move in each and every corner of Kampala, each and every corner of Uganda, their security personnel, you'll get police, you'll get UPDF, you'll get prisons. Now we're also patrolling the Kampala streets with Uganda Prison Service. You'll get intelligence agencies are doing their work. You'll get LODUs. They are trying to work hard to see that these people who are trying to intimidate Ugandans do not succeed. Ugandans should come out. Ugandans should go out and work and do their lawful business, but not to be intimidated. I can assure them that security is guaranteed and we are here to protect them. We shall do whatever it takes to see that these people who are intimidating Ugandans do not succeed.
Afande, over time the problem has been security is executed. In case of riots, and you know they don't tell you now we are going to riot. We can be seated here and the riot starts. But you know the way police handles at that particular time, what confidence can a lay Ugandan have that for me, I'm not going to be taken, you know, by surprise, something is going to take me, you know? What confidence?
First of all, the issue of uprising or strike. The intelligence agencies have done out their work. Those who are trying to plan to come out and demonstrate, they have already been engaged. And since they have already been engaged in one way or another, I doubt whether they will go ahead with their intention. But how we handle people are striking, when people are demonstrating, we use non-lethal weapon, and that is tear gas. But
which was not the case on November 18th.
It was. We used the tear gas. Lost their life through suffocations. Others through other diseases. Or after the after getting tear gas, you are not used to the panic. So people had to lose lives. But we regret. The loss of lives of people who died during that operation.
So, Afande, as we wind up, my prayer is that live ammunition amongst civilians is checked whenever they are dispersing the.
We normally restrain ourselves from using live bullets, unless it is at an extreme case. That's when we use live. Bullets. But normally, to keep public order, in handling public order, if there's any chaos, if there's any demonstration, the first line of defense or the first line that we use are batons.
Yeah.
From baton,
yeah,
we progress to water cannon, tear gas.
It's the last option.
Yes.
Okay, so Afande, as we conclude, please allay the fears of Ugandans. Very many I know are staying home. Our shops are now open because they are very worried, thinking that anything can happen anytime and that they don't want to be caught up in the fracas.
I want to assure Ugandans that their security is guaranteed. We took those audios that were circulating seriously. We investigated them. We have tasked our intelligence agencies to be on ground to see that nobody takes advantage of any situation. We have deployed our officers, as I police, UPDF, prisons, intelligence agencies. If I talk of intelligence agencies, I mean crime intelligence, I mean CMI, I mean ESO. They are safe and they are doing whatever it takes. So if you are out there and you are still fearing, you are still feeling, please come to town, go out, go to your lawful businesses and be intimidated. We are here to protect you. We are here to see that Uganda is safe. And we have that Uganda is safe, to see that Ugandans are safe. Whoever is within Uganda is safe. And we shall take and we shall do that.
No.
So don't sit back. Because you are fearing, you are intimidated. No, don't be intimidated. Just come out. Go and work, go and do your. But you can see people are moving. They said no shops will open. Shops have opened. People have gone to work. So we are here and don't get scared. Come out and work.
Thank you. Patrick Onyango Afande here at Kampala Central Police Station. And issues of security arising out of the post-election period. And he has said that Ugandans need not fear to come to work because the security is tight. They have a joint force of all the security agencies to combat anything that might arise.
All right. Thank you very much, Dina Nalbega Kamengo. She is at Central Police Station. She's just spoken to the Kampala Metropolitan Area spokesperson, police spokesperson, that is Patrick Onyango, and assured us that people, please go on about your businesses. Don't you get worried at all, because security is gulu gulu.
So for those of you that have been hiding in the bushes, like Kamchela Kamengo was saying, get out of those bushes,
get to work.
The shops are open. Apparently, people were scared. People stayed home. Quite a number of them, I think, had stayed home.
Yes.
But the court police is saying that no, there's nothing like that is going to happen to you. The security is there for you. And the most important thing is telling Ugandans not to be intimidated when they see police officers deployed around them. They should be glad that they're around
them.
Yeah,
but you know the November riots are still very, you know, very fresh in the minds of people. If you're just walking around, you may be scared of a stray bullet hitting you. Mm-hmm. And yes, yesterday I was at a shop and someone told me the exact same thing, that there are going to be any riots tomorrow. We've had certain things. And I have listened to the audio as well that is trying to frighten people. Allegedly, the person is speaking from Belgium and telling people that if you dare go to town, there will be consequences and it will be upon
and you.
But it's a good thing to see that, yeah, people actually came out and
this is what the president has been speaking about all along. Foreign interference. People, you're in Belgium and you're instigating
the public.
No, but this is a Ugandan, allegedly. But I don't even think that, because the person says, I am reporting from Belgium. Come on, anyone can sit, anyone report from Belgium. From and of course, also reports with security, they were saying these people are lying to certain opposition members. But also Noop has come out to strongly deny any links with the people who may intend to cause chaos.
Absolutely.
Up to 7, saying they have nothing to do with it, and they've advised people to go ahead and do whatever it is that
stop
they need
listening
to
rumor mongers. Mm-hmm. Anyway, the papers are out today. We have the new vision out at 2,000 Uganda shillings. We also have Bukede that is out at 1,000 Uganda shillings. So let's quickly get into what's happening in today's new vision. Dina will be taking us later through Bukede, but let's quickly take a look at the new vision. The headlining story today is schools reopening should you out. There will be no automatic promotion, so get yourself a copy. It's on page 3, and there's a very wonderful graphic detail here on the Uganda Airbus A330neo at a glance. So deep, interesting graphics here. A pause petition. Museveni assembles 20 lawyers. We have talked about that. COVID-19 vaccine. Government to buy 18 million doses.
Well, universities are adopting to online learning. This actually could become a permanent thing, by the way, Lynn.
The new normal.
Yes, the new normal of ordeal.
And Chagulanyi is accusing security of sabotage. Yeah, so it's a detailed story you need to get to see. NRM sweeps youth member of parliament polls in all regions. Interesting development there. Parliament speaker race hots up. I know. This is a very interesting one.
And seeing five faces is a breath of fresh air. We've been saying that we need a few other people to come and break the tie. That is, this seat that is being patronized by two people. To just see some other faces there. So we have five people you want to
let me tell you
what's in the paper.
My most interesting one. Parliament honors Chiveji Nja and calls for free COVID-19 tests. Kabaka dedicates birthday to HIV/AIDS fight. Right, there's a whole lot of interesting stories if you get yourself a copy of the new vision. But Lydia, I want us to quickly go through it because we have something and very interesting discussion coming up. Now,
yes,
pass all levels equally here. Entrepreneurship skills. Geography paper 2 solutions. We have geography continuation, so get yourself a copy. And now Wednesdays we carry the Toto magazine. Yes, Toto magazine for the Totos at home. Jonan and Peter, the nature lover, you need to read this. Meet world's female speakers of parliament. Very fantastic read there, so get yourself a copy of Toto.
We also have Mwalimu. Mwalimu, we read the lead story that we have is about university adapting to online learning. This is something that may be with us for a very long time. They're also saying the education curriculum must match the changing global trends. That is a call that is going on all over the world.
Mm,
yes,
that's
that
very
is what
true.
We have in Mwalimu.
I mean, there's an interesting one here. Modification in education curricula must match changing global demands. Mm-hmm. Wow. Oh, and Uganda needs a digital strategy for schools and varsities. I think that's very key. Mm-hmm. And into business, this is World Trade Organization warns of slow global services trade recovery. Yeah. Ah, Ongwen, what lies at stake? Ongwen ICC verdict. Yeah, so we're going to see how that goes. Community news, and also we're seeing Busoga election losers counting costs. Bambi, sorry.
While schools are struggling to feed their candidates, is that concern of schools?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yes. And international news, South Africa passes second wave peak as fast vaccines land. The other day we were talking about how countries want to work together, but individually. And also, being a Wednesday, sportswoman, no hope on Van Dijk. We have glimmer of hope as teams train. It's reconciliation path. Former PAU treasurer, PAU is the Pool Association of Uganda, cleared of 28.4 million debt. And we feel inspired. Bleak hails Cheyune Nsubuga. That's all in today's New Vision. Seka, what is in Daily Monitor?
Of course, so Daily Monitor is also equally out at only 2,000 shillings. Reading the story, cabinet reopens P6, S3, S5 classes. Mm-hmm. And that story is tucked up on page 4 of today's monitor. And they're also writing about how Bobby lawyers failed to serve Museveni. And I also have a picture of the new Airbus, and also saying that government import 18 million COVID vaccine doses. Ministry unveils new plan to regulate land. And they're also writing about the new youth MPs. So you can get yourself a copy of today's Daily Monitor and find out who these new MPs are. And of course, in sports, we're seeing focus on defense, final roster out. And McKinstry hurting, hopeful for AFCON. And then lastly, Uganda Hippos progress faces Tanzania's test. That's all in today's Daily Monitor. Get yourself only 2,000 shillings and buy yourself a copy. To read more about these stories.
Yes, indeed. And that's in the dailies. Like I said, Dina will later, in just a bit later, she'll take us through Bukede. Mm-hmm. But we need to quickly rush for some small time coffee. But Becky Cynthia Nachimera is here and she'll take us through some sporting updates.
Urban Today, brought to you by
Metropolitan International University. We offer postgraduate diplomas, bachelor's degree, diploma, certificate programs, weekend, day and evening. Registrations in progress at our campuses.